Record-breaking humanoid underwater drone robotics with haptic feedback allow users to feel with their hands. OceanOne has swum through sunken ships, planes, as well as a submarine, and plunged down to a depth of nearly 1 kilometer with its unique features that enable its users to feel as though they are physically interacting with the underwater world by providing sensory feedback to their hands. The underwater drone humanoid robot, designed by Mika Robotics and Stanford experts, physically shields people from potentially dangerous and inaccessible underwater environments, while linking their abilities, knowledge, experience, and intuition to the task at hand. OceanOne's top half is a humanoid robot with 2 robotic arms, 2 cameras in the face for operators to see in 3D, and its lower half has 8 multi-directional thrusters, which enable precise underwater maneuvering. The underwater robot's haptic feedback system relies on touch and stereo vision to create incredibly real sensations for the operator to allow them to feel like they're at the bottom of the ocean. Through the OceanOne's robotic eyes, the human operators can see the environment in high definition. OceanOne serves 2 goals: to discover areas that no one else has explored before, and to demonstrate that human touch, vision, and interaction can reach locations that were previously far removed from us. While OceanOne had numerous memorable adventures and accomplishments during 2 long-distance trips across the Mediterranean, the most notable achievement of its crew was the demonstration of operational autonomy for more than 1,000 meters down. It marked the first time ever that underwater robots were capable of providing a haptic feedback-based interaction at this depth. The OceanOne robot's journey to the 1 kilometer mark was an extended effort that started with countless hours of design, experimentation, and assembly with team members in the lab, dozens of trips to the Stanford pool for debugging, and a myriad of lessons to be learned before facing the unpredictability of the deep sea. The first version of this underwater drone humanoid robot was built with the intention of being able to reach depths of only 200 meters instead of 1 kilometer. So, to allow the robot to go deeper, the scientists adapted the body to incorporate a special foam made from glass microspheres. These glass microspheres provide buoyancy and are strong enough to withstand the massive pressure at 1 kilometer depths, which is 100 times more than that of sea level. The robotic arms contain an oil-filled spring mechanism that compresses the oil to match the pressure outside to prevent collapse or cushioning of the electronic components. The researchers also revised several tiny components across OceanOne to limit the amount of compressed air within individual parts while keeping the robot as small as possible. OceanOne included additional improvements that increased the flexibility of its head and arm motions, as well as 2 different types of hands. The OceanOne project is not just a showcase for the latest innovations in haptic feedback technology, underwater drone robotics, and human-robot interaction, but also offers new possibilities for underwater engineering and marine science activities, including checking and fixing boats and infrastructure, such as bridges, piers, and pipelines that are submerged. Other expeditions are planned for several locations across the globe, such as lost cities in deep waters, coral reefs, and archaeologically valuable wrecks that lie at depths that are beyond the reach of human beings. These kinds of humanoid underwater drone robotics can go deep underwater to look for and acquire materials, build infrastructure, and conduct emergency recovery or disaster prevention operations. But in the future, they can also be adapted to operate deep inside mines, on top of mountains, or even in space. Breakthrough artificial intelligence translates brainwaves into natural language to literally read people's minds. Scientists are now able to read your thoughts by using an AI model specifically developed to interpret brainwaves. The non-invasive innovation invented at the University of Texas is expected to aid those who are unable to speak so they can communicate easily for the first time. Moreover, this AI tech is also able to decode human speech in real time. It works by providing functional magnetic resonance imaging, fMRI, to the machine learning algorithm, which reconstructs any stimuli the person is listening to or thinking about into natural language. For example, participants listened to stories narrated by a storyteller while scientists scanned the brain regions associated with natural language. Then, they transferred the brain scan data to the machine learning decoder, which produced an overview of what the subject had been listening to. Until now, this procedure had only been achieved by implanting electrodes inside the brain. The new technology provides an idea of the patient's thoughts by recognizing patterns in the brain scans using machine learning, but it cannot discern what the patients are thinking word for word. This is because the human brain converts complex ideas into smaller pieces, which correspond to a part of the overall thought process. Ideas could appear as straightforward as just one word, like the word dog, or as intricate as I need to walk my dog. The brain also has its own alphabet of sorts, composed of 42 elements that represent an idea, such as size, color, or location, and blends all of these together to create more complicated ideas. Each letter is processed by a distinct part of the brain. Therefore, when you combine all these different components, it's possible to literally read someone's mind. The three brain regions analyzed were the prefrontal network, the classical language network, and the parietal temporal occipital association network. The machine learning algorithm was later given the scans to look at features in the audio with patterns of recorded brain activity. The system also showed that it could take the scanned data and transform it into a story based on the material that the team discovered, which was consistent with the ideas of the stories narrated by the actors. While the AI algorithm may not be capable of breaking down each word that a person is thinking, it can decipher whatever story each person has heard. The study, published on Bioxiv, tells a story. Look for a text message from my wife telling me that she had changed her mind and she would be returning. This algorithm decoded the message to be, quote, deceive her for some reason, I thought maybe she would come to me and say she misses me. The machine learning algorithm isn't perfect yet, and made some mistakes like confusing characters' pronouns and the use of the first and third person. The AI knows what's happening pretty accurately, but not who is doing the things. In additional tests, the AI could fairly accurately explain the plot of a silent movie that the participants were watching in the scanner, and it was even able to retell a story that the participants imagined themselves telling in their minds. As the next step, the research team aims to develop this technology so it can be used in brain-computer interfaces designed for people who cannot speak or type. But over the longer term, this technology could help humans to merge with computers entirely and bring about a future hive mind of humanity with shared consciousness between all humans and machines. By the way, did you know machine learning engineers make a median salary of $135,000 per year with bonuses and benefits, all while working remotely? What if you could start learning for free today from world-famous AI researcher Andrew Ng, the co-founder of Google Brain, to work as an artificial intelligence engineer from home? Well, you can. So get started for free today on Coursera.org to earn your deep learning specialization online at your own pace. And join the AI industry where there is a massive shortage of talent that companies are battling for a hire. Click now and start cashing in on the artificial intelligence revolution today.